It seems pretty clear that there's plenty of winter left, and that means we need to have a good book to curl up with. We've made our way to Majors & Quinn and Annie Metcalf for some recommendations. It's good to see you.
It's good to see you too.
What do you have up your sleeve today?
Some great winter fiction. We're going to start with Early Riser by Jasper Ford. It is a strange little book about an alternate version of our world where humanity has survived by literally hibernating through the winter, and there's a young man who stays awake all winter to protect us from things that go bump in the night.
Next one is this little slim book called The Hunting Party.
Yes, The Hunting Party is a super streamlined murder mystery set in the Scottish Highlands. It's a New Year's Eve party with longtime friends that goes very wrong.
And a one-name title, Tentacle.
Tentacle, yeah. Rita Indiana is a Caribbean musician and writer, and this is a really interesting book about a post-climate catastrophe Dominican Republic and a young woman who needs to save the universe by first becoming the man that she was meant to be.
We have a lot of history buffs in our audience. What do you have for them?
I've got The Heartbreak of Wounded Knee by David Troyer. People may know him. He was born on the Leech Lake Reservation in Minnesota, but he's a great historian and novelist, and this is a new essential piece of work on Native American peoples.
And tell us about The Souls of Yellow Folk.
I just wanted to make sure people knew about Wesley Yang and his essays. He's a fantastic writer, winner of National Magazine Writing Award, and these are from anything to from online dating to the Virginia Tech shooting to tiger mothers, and it's about race and culture in America.
I love weaving in essays because they're perfect for bed if you just don't want to commit so heavily to one thing. The Gilded Wolves.
Gilded Wolves is my favorite young adult title of the moment. It is in an alternate version of Belle Epoque Paris, so there's magic, and it takes place in the 1890s. Super diverse and fun.
And you have something very fun here for Prince fans. Tell us about this.
I just had to show everyone Little Red Velvet, which is a baking book based on the work of Prince. So it's fabulous.
Loving that. That's just great. You know, one that I'm just finishing now is Michelle Obama's autobiography or memoir,
which is just Becoming.
And that has been a mega bestseller.
It was absolutely our bestseller of the year last year, even having only been available from November through December.
Yeah, Becoming. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Thanks so much, Annie, as always.
Thank you.
We have all these titles for you at carolevin.com. All you have to do is look at the Saturday show page. Send it back to you.